President Biden is still struggling in the polls, and he's got an approval rating of around 33%. This is causing serious concerns with Democratic strategists who feel that Biden may already have lost the election. Okay, here it is. This is not me. This is, if you look at what all the polls are showing, here's what's killing him. Immigration, high inflation, his age, Kamala Harris.
Right.
Killing him. And there were, in lesser degree, third-party candidates like Robert Kennedy. Donors are leaving the party. Just over, if you take a look at what's happening with Gaza, okay? Jewish donors who have pumped up the Democratic Party for decades are saying, really? You got Kamala Harris out there attacking us, and you want our money? Because of that, even the money raising is taking a different turn, hasn't it?
Well, it's a slow slog summer. There's no excitement there. There's no joy. And it is everything, all the trials are not having the impact that they thought it would. It's not a big factor. It's boiling down to the economy over and over again. And people do not have confidence in the Biden economy. And I think that's the other big issue that keeps resonating. I think they're hoping that abortion will rescue the campaign.
I don't think it does. I don't think the numbers are there.
It might. I mean, it's still, among women, it's a huge issue.
Of course but, it is. It should be.
But I don't know. The minority vote is not going the way that they think it was going to go.
Well, you've got Hamas, the Israel-Hamas issue. You've got the Ukraine issue. You have inflation. You have all these things that everybody seems to be ignoring in the Democratic Party. And the critics are saying, really, your campaign is that we have to elect him because democracy is at risk with Trump? That's their argument.
Right.
You think that resonates with the average American? They don't even understand the intricacies of that argument. And so I think the Democrats they're running out of ideas as to what is going to propel him. I don't know if you saw this number. I was startled by it. But they were talking about his approval rating, what it was.
It's about the same, somewhere around 34.
30, well, yeah.
And I mean,
started at 31.
Yeah.
And that was at the time, I guess a year ago. And now it's 31.4, something
right,
like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
So I'm not seeing any change. I don't know. Do you get rid of him? The freeze that he had the other day was startling. You know, I don't know if you saw it. Mm-hmm. The Juneteenth celebration, but even corporate media who protects him left and right, they're up showing this freeze that takes place where he literally for a minute and a half stood frozen, incapable. His eyes were fixed. He was frozen. People look at that and they go, "This scares the hell out of me."
Yeah.
You know, and then you what? So what's your other side?
Right,
a lunatic.
What this
you got,
ranting? And,
you've got yeah, this ranting right. lunatic. Out there on the other side, and people say, "My God, give us a candidate!"
Right?
You know, give us a candidate.
Yeah, it's a dismal feeling. I mean, I think that what happens in the polling booth is going to be interesting.
I'm kind of tired of hearing that the only numbers where it comes to what we ought to be looking at that the polls. I don't believe much in polls unless it's in a 3% kind of range. Most of them are ridiculous.
Right.
But you hear that argument, well, we're going to find out on the election day. We'll see what the numbers are. You can't just wait for that.
Right.
You have to take some action ahead of time. And all this stuff is pointing towards we need a new Republican candidate and we need a new Democratic candidate.
Right.
Give the American people something to choose from. Rick, that's all for this week.
All right. I think we did enough damage.
All these segments are going to be posted right here on this channel in the coming weeks, so make sure you're subscribed. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you stories every week that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers don't allow for it. If they tell the story, they're going to lose advertising dollars, or their political connections are so Democrat or so Republican that the media can't color outside the lines. We don't have that problem here, as you can tell. Hope to see you next week.
The
that it had helped dirty money flow through its branches around the world, including at least 800...
Plaintiffs allege that the defendants provided money and medical goods to terrorist groups Hezbollah and Jaish al-Mahdi.
This is a well-organized business for these individuals that carry out these attacks. Terrorism is a business, and they run it like a business.
They knew about what was going on for a decade. They absolutely, absolutely, no question about it, knew that HSBC was washing money. They had every reason to understand it was for terrorism and it was for drug cartels. Took no action whatsoever.
These banks are involved. Their accounts are connected, and they're using them to mask the transactions. The more complicated they can make the transactions, the more distance they can put between the bad guys and the seemingly legitimate purpose of these funds.
They pay $1.9 billion, which is a drop in the bucket compared to what they've made, and nobody goes to prison. These CEOs, these bankers that made this decision, they're safe at home. They know what they've done. It's resulted in the death of Americans, contractors and soldiers, not just hundreds, but thousands. And we look the other way because they don't look like criminals. The die is cast. The people that are responsible for are on Wall Street.
And they don't look like criminals. It's almost a suspension of disbelief. Sometimes I'll have people call me and say, is this real? Do they really get away with this? Yeah, they do.